As you have noticed a number of times already in this course, we often like to look at the same problem in multiple ways because different ways in which you look at it allow you different insights in different circumstances. And in preparation of talking about LU factorization with partial pivoting, it turns out to be useful to look at Gaussian elimination, LU factorization, slightly differently yet. Okay? So, let's say that the right-looking algorithm for LU factorization, the one that we showed was the same as Gaussian elimination, has proceeded so that A00 has been updated with an upper triangular matrix. This part has been updated with the rest of that upper triangular matrix, or at least of those rows, and this part of the matrix has been updated accordingly. Okay, and we have a bunch of zeros sitting right here. So this is the current step in Gaussian elimination, or the current step in LU factorization, where we want to create zeros here and update that matrix there. Now it turns out that the operations that you perform there can be thought of as the application of a very special matrix. And what is that special matrix? That special matrix looks like this. Oops, this should be negative L21. And then the identity here. So, it's the identity matrix, except below the one that is in the same position as this alpha 1,1, we have a vector L21, except that we take the negative of that vector. Okay, this right here is called a Gauss transform. Okay. Let's multiply this out. Okay. This first matrix is this times that plus this times that plus this times that. So we get A00 here. And by similar reasoning, we get A01 and A02 here. Okay, the first rows, the rows that we've already processed, are left alone. This row right here becomes this times that plus this times that plus this times that. So we get a zero here. Then we get an alpha 1,1 here. And we get a A12 transpose here. The current row is left alone, just like in LU factorization or Gaussian elimination. Now, this right here is this times that plus this times that plus this times that, so we retain the zeros there. And now, this right here becomes, let's see, this times that plus this times that plus this times that. So that becomes minus L21 times alpha 11 plus A21. And then this right here becomes minus L21 times A12 transpose plus A22. And you can just check that for yourself. By now you should be very familiar with how to do partition matrix multiplication. Now, the purpose of the game is to introduce zeros here. So we would like this result here to be zero. And it's not hard to see that if you pick L21 to be A21 divided by alpha 11, then this expression becomes zero. Where have we seen that before? That's the computation of the multipliers. Okay? And then once you have done that, notice that this is the same as A22 minus L21 A12 transpose. And notice that that's exactly the update with the rank 1 update that shows up in our LU factorization algorithm as well, the one that was equivalent to Gaussian elimination. So, the point is, computing and applying this particular Gauss transform has the same net effect as doing one step of our LU factorization algorithm. Okay? Now, what does that mean? What that means is that if you take your matrix A and you compute your first Gauss transform, the one corresponding to the first step of Gaussian elimination or of LU factorization, and then you apply another one, and you do that until you get down to Ln minus 1, then the result of that is our upper triangular matrix. Okay. What that means is that you can bring all of these different Gauss transforms to the other side and show that this is actually equal to Ln minus 1 inverse, Ln minus 2 inverse, all the way down to L1 inverse and then L0 inverse times the matrix U. Each of the Gauss transforms is a lower triangular matrix. You may remember that if you multiply lower triangular matrices together, you get a lower triangular matrix. So all of this is actually a lower triangular matrix. You would hope that that is exactly the same L as you encountered when you computed LU factorization. Now, we have some exercises that walk you through the fact that indeed, if you multiply all of these together, you simply get L. And if you think about it, what that really means is, remember, we created our L by simply taking the L21 and placing it over the zeros that you computed. So it must be the case that if you multiply all of these inverses of the Gauss transforms together, then the L that you get should be the one that you get by simply taking these multiplier vectors that you computed along the way and placing them in the correct position in the unit lower triangular matrix. Well, let's see if we can prove that through a couple of homeworks.